We have developing news this morning. A 14-year-old boy from Georgia now stands accused of shooting and killing four people at his high school, and he's going to be transferred to a youth detention facility today.
Sheriff's deputies say he went on a rampage, injuring nine others. KTLA's Eric Spillman in the newsroom with the details. Eric, good morning.
Morning, Megan. Morning, Chris. This 14-year-old boy had been on the FBI's radar for more than a year. They say he had posted threats online before, and yesterday authorities say he showed up at his high school with an AR-style weapon and opened fire.
Be with us, bless us, and walk with us each day as we go forward.
A minister tries to console a community. Young people pray and grieve and cry. They light candles and leave flowers outside a school. It is the aftermath of yet another school shooting, this one in Winder, Georgia, 50 miles northwest of Atlanta. It happened during second period at Appalachie High School. Witnesses say the 14-year-old student, identified as Colt Gray, left his algebra class and then came back armed with a rifle. He tried to walk back into class, but the door was locked. At that point, he began shooting in the hallway, killing two teachers and two students. Ultimately, he surrendered to school resource officers and was arrested. But for what seemed like a very long time, students throughout the school heard the gunfire and took shelter under their desks, waiting for it to end.
I was listening and you could hear gunshots like just ringing out through the school, and like you're just wondering like which one of those is going to be somebody that you're like best friends with or somebody that you love. And it's like, it's really like a terrifying thing.
So in case you're wondering, it's not a drill.
Cell phone video recorded by a student shows what it was like inside a classroom during the lockdown. You can hear the girl sobbing in fear. Now, the four people who were killed were identified as 39-year-old Richard Aspinwall, a math teacher, and another teacher, 53-year-old Christina Irimi, as well as two 14-year-old students, Mason Schirmerhorn and Christian Angulo. Schirmerhorn is described by friends and family as a lighthearted kid who liked reading, telling jokes, playing video games, and visiting Disney World. As for the suspected killer, the FBI says in 2023, Georgia police went to his home after he'd made threats online. They interviewed the boy and his father. The dad said there were guns in the house, but he told cops his son did not have unsupervised access to them.
They conducted an investigation at that time, and there was no probable cause for arrest or to take any additional law enforcement action.
However, one of the suspected shooter's classmates says she thinks law enforcement missed the signs that should have shown them the young man was violent and dangerous.
The lives that were taken here today, all the students that died, the teachers that died, all the students that had to watch their teachers or their fellow classmates die, that's the consequence of the action of not taking control where you should be.
Now, the accused killer is 14 years old, but authorities say he will be charged with multiple murders and that he will be tried as an adult. We'll send it back to you.